Hey, what's up guys, Henry Neal here, and I have here the Huawei Y6P, Huawei's new budget addition to the Y series of smartphones. This phone packs a huge 5000 mAh battery, 3GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage, and a triple camera setup at the back for a competitive price of 64,900 Naira. Putting it in the same range as the Samsung Galaxy A11, the Infinix Hot 9, the Xiaomi S12 and the Tecno Spark 5. So in the box you get the Huawei Y6P, a SIM ejector tool, a quick start guide, a micro USB to USB-A data slash charging cable, a 10-watt charger and a pair of earphones. This phone is reminiscent of the Huawei Nova 3i. They've got very similar designs and honestly this could pass for a Nova 3i. I have the midnight black variant here, but there's also a phantom purple and emerald green color option. Moving on, the Y6P feels quite good in my hands and it's got a polycarbonate backplate and a glass front, but you really need to look close to know that the backplate isn't glass. But plastic isn't a bad thing and by now you probably know my stance on plastic phones. You have the volume and power buttons to the right and they're quite clicky. On the left, the triple SIM slot bay that houses two nano SIMs and an SD card slot that's expandable up to 512GB. And there's also a noise cancellation microphone at the top of the device, and at the bottom we have the 3.5mm headphone port, a microphone, a micro USB charging port and speaker grills. Setup was quite easy and I was done in about a minute and a half. The device has got some heft to it, which gives it a reassuring feel in hand, and thanks to the slender frame, the Y6P is super comfortable to hold. At the back, you'll find a triple camera setup stacked vertically, and the camera module has literally almost no bump. And placing it on the table is free of wobbles. For the display, the Y6P has a 6.3-inch TFT IPS LCD panel with a now dated drop-notch design and a pre-applied screen protector. It has a resolution of 1600 by 720 pixels, an aspect ratio of 20:9, and a PPI of 278. It's not the best 720p screen out there, but we still get sharp details and good colors that's customizable in the settings if you prefer cooler or warmer tones. The single downward firing speaker can get really loud, but if you need it to be even louder, the Y6P has a feature called Super Sound that boosts audio volumes to as loud as 88 decibels, but you'd quickly find that this isn't the most pleasing volume level as you'll get distorted sounds. I would advise leaving it between 65 to 70 decibels for the best sound output using the external speakers. It's a good thing that the Y6P still has a headphone port so you can easily use your preferred headphone if using the speaker isn't your thing. You also have Bluetooth 5.0 for high fidelity wireless audio. For biometrics, the Y6P has a rear place fingerprint reader and it's quite fast and accurate, and I found myself using this more than the face unlock and the PIN options. The face unlock works quite well, but in dark rooms or low-lit environments, you may have false reads. When it comes to software, the Huawei Y6P runs on Android 10, skinned with EMUI 10.1. This skin should be familiar to any previous Huawei smartphone user. It's got the home screen or app drawer options and has options for dark mode, ebook mode, one-handed mode and more. We can't talk about software without talking about the giant in the room, the lack of Google Mobile services. A number of you may be wary of Huawei devices due to the US-China saga and Google's ban on Huawei using their mobile services. But if you've seen my video on if you should buy a Huawei phone in 2020, then you know that there's nothing to be scared of. Huawei relies on its own version of the Play Store, which is the App Gallery, which basically comes with a lot of in-demand apps. And for very popular apps that rely on Google mobile services such as YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, the App Gallery basically redirects you to web versions of those apps or to a link external to the Play Store to download those apps. The web versions also allow you to add shortcuts to your homepage so they launch just like a native app. It's a bit of a different experience to the native apps, but it works. Under the hood, the Y6P sports a MediaTek Helio P22 octa-core processor, a PowerVR GE8320 GPU, 3GB of RAM, 64GB of storage. The phone performs smooth when working on basic tasks like switching apps, scrolling through apps, navigating the UI, taking photos and playing games. But having too many apps in the background can cause stutters, so it's best to keep it minimal. Games play smoothly, but you also need to clear most apps in the background and set the phone to performance mode to have a much smoother experience. That being said, the Y6P will play almost all games at low to medium settings with no deal-breaking lag. It's worth knowing, however, that most of the major games such as PUBG, Call of Duty and Mobile Legends and a lot more are not yet available on the app gallery, so you may have to find a way to sideload them yourself. Hopefully, Huawei will add them to the app gallery soon. There's a 5000 mAh battery in this phone and we have a micro USB charger included in the package. The charger fills up the battery in about 2.5 hours and a full charge on this phone typically lasts more than a day of moderate to heavy use. Screen time typically falls between 5 to 6 hours of use. The Y6P has a triple camera setup consisting of a 13 megapixel main, a 5 megapixel wide and a 2 megapixel depth sensor. On the dual drop notch is an 8 megapixel selfie camera. As for photo quality, the rear cameras produce vibrant and sharp images, especially in good lighting conditions. You'll also notice that there's some sort of color enhancements to make the images pop, which isn't bad. I like it, but not everyone will. Photos taken at night looked okay, but they were a bit dull as well. You should know, however, that there is no night mode in the camera app. This, however, isn't a deal breaker in my opinion. The wide-angle lens has the same color reproduction as the standard lens, but also has some fisheye effects on the photos. There's an aperture mode to help you take portrait shots with blurry background. It works, but the edge detection isn't perfect. For selfies, the photos have cooler tones and look clear and smooth. You'll be happy posting shots from these cameras to social media, but won't be great for print work as they contain some noise. As for videos, the Y6P can shoot up to 1080p at 30 frames per second. There's no OIS here, so you may want to get a gimbal or use a tripod. As for the price, the Huawei Y6P falls at the affordable price point of 64,900 Naira, which is a solid deal considering you're getting a 5000 mAh battery, 64GB of storage, 3GB of RAM and good cameras. Now, if not having Google Play services isn't a deal breaker and you can take some time to set up all the apps you need that aren't available in the Huawei app gallery, then the Huawei Y6P is an even better deal than some of the other phones in this price range. Well, that's it for this review. What are your thoughts on the Huawei Y6P? Does it meet your needs and are you willing to take a chance on this device despite the lack of Google services? Let me know in the comment section of this video. Do like, subscribe and turn on notifications so you're alerted when I post new videos like this one. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.